Yo, this is Rick Mahorn, the bad boy, giving a shout out to my man Drew, Detroit Drew. Make sure you tune in on his YouTube channel, Detroit Drew, bad boy.
Detroit Drew, Woodward Sports. Yeah, Detroit Drew, Woodward Sports.
Yo, what's good, peeps? Before we talk Cade and the Detroit Pistons, just in quick, in case you guys haven't seen it, we officially hit 5,000 subscribers. It's insane. We continue to grow, and I'm sure Cade and everything that comes with the draft is only going to make it go up. I appreciate the ones who were here since day one, and I appreciate all the new people who are subbing. It's really awesome, man. I'm meeting a lot of people, and it's just cool to build relationships with some of you guys, man. A lot of you guys are sending me articles and news coverage all the time. A lot of you guys just support me and always have my back. So from the bottom of my heart, I appreciate that. I don't know what I'm gonna do for 5K yet. I see some people want another stand-up special. I see a lot of people are just commenting different things. So before we talk about this, you guys can comment as many times as you want to, but what do you guys want to see from me for 5K, man? Is it stand-up, WWE video, beer shower, you name it, whatever gets the most likes and people request the most, I will do it. So leave that down below. But now let's go ahead and talk about the man, the myth, and the legend, Cade Cunningham. Pistons have the first overall pick. Cade, and before the Pistons got the pick, was the projected number one overall pick. See, a lot of people are saying Green, which is cool, you know, whatever, outside of the Pistons. The pick is Cade. Bottom line right there, okay? But this is from Bleacher Report. Bleacher Report, don't know if they did an interview with them or whatever, but said that Cade would be very excited if the Pistons took him number one overall. For one, means more money. Two, means more national coverage because you're the first overall pick, and it looks good on your resume when it's all said and done. And three, look what the Detroit Pistons have to offer. I said this the same thing when LaMelo Ball was coming out last year. If the Pistons were able to get him, he would be happy to come here because of all the talent. The talent has now shifted, and the talent has now gotten even better than it was last year. Even though our record was worse, you look at Sadiq Bey, he's one of the best rookies to come out of the draft class last year. Beef Stew is going to be nice for guards. He opens up some space, and he's a good defender, even though he gets dunked on a lot, but hey, neither here nor there. And then you look at Jeremy Grant, who's now on Team USA, playing with some of those guys, who's getting the recognition. He was a 20-point per game scorer. Wow. I butchered that one. But you start seeing all the young pieces we have, though. It's like the Frank Jacksons, if we bring him back, he'll be a good player off the bench. The Josh Jacksons, he had a great season last year. He really improved, and he's going to continue to improve under Dwayne Casey in the Detroit Pistons system. But then you brought in guys like Diallo, if you bring him back, which if we get Cade, whatever we get the first pick, it's going to be a lot of our cap space. We got to bring back Frank Jackson or Diallo. Don't know if we'll be able to bring back both, but whatever one you want to put there, they're going to be good players coming off the bench. But then you got Killian, who's a great defender. I think him and Cade will fit really well together defensively. On the offensive side of the ball, it'll probably take some time, but they will get there. But defensively, that's going to be a good matchup for the Pistons, man. We got some guys that, if we get Cade, we got good size. We got good defensive IQ of getting into the passing lane and first forcing turnovers. It'll be good. So, I mean, everything's lining up for Cade to be a good fit for the Pistons. I said perfect before. I don't know if perfect's the right word, but it's a good fit. He's going to come in. He's going to have an opportunity. He'll be a day one starter. There's not too many guys on this team right now that I would say is better than him. I don't know if I'd say anyone's better than him, but he is unproven. He hasn't played in the NBA yet, but he will be a day one starter selected by the Detroit Pistons. You look at what we did last year is, I think Killian was the only rookie starting last year, but in a matter of games, Sadiq was starting. And then whenever Plumlee got hurt or needed some rest, Beef Stew was starting, and he had some of his best games at that point in time. He even had a 2020 game. All the young guys look promising, even Saben Lee. But then you got prospects like Sekou, who have shown talent and potential, but are still getting there. And he's doing everything right now. As you see all the videos, Pistons Talk is posting, Sekou's working out again. He's practicing more dribbling skills and shooting skills. He's working on his game. And as a young guy that really hasn't gotten much of an opportunity, you want to see that because it shows that he's not giving up. He's trying to fight, scratch, and claw his way to getting to some, not just a starting position, but some minutes, some consistent minutes. And that's what I'm looking for from Sekou. It's just improve here and there, man. He doesn't have to come out and drop 20 or 30 or be a 10 and 10 guy at all. Just come out and show us something else, you know? But for Cade, man, everything's lining up. The stars are aligning. The heavens are opening up and saying, come to Detroit. Come here. You're going to have fun. You're going to be a great player. And the team is going to be built around you. All the guys we drafted last year, maybe with the exception of Killian, are going to fit well with Cade. Saban will come off the bench and be his backup, and it'll be a nice 1-2 punch. But Sadiq and Beef Stew are going to help out Cade a lot, especially coming out of college where he got double teamed a lot. He was able to pick apart the zone, which I really, really like. He'll be able to find the Sadiq Bays and the Beef Stews when they are open and get them in the right position and stuff. So I'm excited that he is excited about potentially coming here. And that's something that you want in a draft prospect, because he's going to come in and take it serious. You know, guys who go number one to a crappy team, I mean, yeah, they're happy, they're collecting a paycheck, but they're not motivated until they get older and mature a little bit. Some guys don't take it serious enough. I think if Cade comes here, he's going to take it serious, and it's going to be a fun team to watch, just at the very least. But what do you guys think about Cade being excited at the Pistons select him number one overall? I know. Is it breaking news? No. But there's not a whole lot else to talk about. I have uploaded in a little bit, so I figured I'd give my 2 cents on it. But leave your thoughts down below. Instagram, Twitter, DSM members in the description. Check it all out. And I'll see you guys in the next one. And that's the bottom line, because Double D said so. Peace.